Now, the stone circle they were talking about is this right here. Now, remember that book in that book in the sealed library that was talking about a stone circle and how the you had to do something in like a proper order? Well, this is actually it. But we can't actually do anything with this until much later in the game, so for now, it's useless. Symbol that looks like a clock. But anyway, here is Mount Zenom. But before we actually climb the mountain, I will be right back. Yes, this is Mount Zenom, the location of the first seal. Will we be able to save it? Who knows? You know what they say about Phase 1 always succeeding? Or is this really Phase 1? No, I guess this is more Phase 2. I guess Phase 1 was technically like stealing the teardrop and all that. Also, I think these guys can paralyze you. They either paralyze you or they cause flash, I think? I actually forget what the flash status effect does. So judging from the name, I think it might, like, maybe blind you? It might be like this game's version of blind. Wild Arms 1 is the only Wild Arms game that actually has the flash status. So I'm not... And it's also kind of a rare status too, so... I'm not really entirely sure what it does. Got a heal berry. Got another lucky card, which I should probably use on the boss. And more shriekers. Nah, I'm not gonna use that. Oh, how I wish I had the high magic right now so I could hit all these things at once. You know, using Psycho Crack might actually be kind of pointless. Because Jack's still not killing these things in one hit. Should probably have Jack and Rudy just physically attack one. Should kill it. Yeah, seems it does. We're a little bit underpowered due to lacking... Oh, look at Cecilia's little dance there! That happens on random chance, after some battles. I think that's the first time she's done it, I don't remember seeing it before. I usually mash through the, you know, the battle results pretty fast. Anyway, the blue circlet is a left-hand item, which prevents paralysis, I believe. Again? Come on, game, give me some different enemy combinations, good grief. Yeah, there's... Oh yeah, Shriek causes a lot of status effects. Cecilia's got paralysis and forgetfulness, which... I believe forgetfulness prevents you from gaining experience points? Yeah, that is what it does, I remember. So, need to use a toy hammer on her. Rudy's silenced, which is hilarious because he can't even use magic. Actually, it's even more funny when you consider the fact that he's a silent protagonist. Although not entirely, because remember, he does talk sometimes. Like, twice in the entire game. these things suck. But we got rid of them all. At least I got another one of those. Okay. There we go. Now this grass here can be burnt with a lighter. Oh, at least I got something new now. Tiny edges. They look like mutated Eevee squirrels. Kind of. And Cecilia leveled up. I think we go in here. More shriekers. I get really tired of seeing this enemy sometimes. I think about it, how do these things shriek when they don't even have mouths? It's actually very odd. Actually, now that I think about it, I think there are chests outside and up a little bit. Hobgoblin. Stronger than your typical goblin. I always wonder what hobgoblin meant anyway. Like, what does the hob mean? You hit them and they sound like cats, but they attack you and they sound like friggin' dragons. Oh yes, there we go. Good thing I went back. Ah, secret sign. Now this is an item which reduces the MP cost for one of Jack's fast draws, but there's no sense using it on the first two. It's best to save them for one of his later fast draws, which is called Magnum Fang. In my opinion, it's pretty much the best fast draw for him. It's not technically his strongest, but I guess you could say it's the most versatile. Because his strongest Vastraw requires him to be at low HP in order for it to, like, have, you know, in order for it to cause, like, a tremendous amount of damage against the enemy, so... Well, Magnum Fang is essentially like an upgraded version of the next fast draw that we're going to be getting for him shortly. Hopefully they don't shriek again and make me forget again. Oh, good. Hey, good job dodging that. I hate having to use flame to kill it, like, when it's gonna have so little HP left, but Cecilia's just not strong enough to kill it. Oh, well. I've been stocking up on magic carrots, so I can use one of those when we get to the boss. Cursed mushroom of death. Oh, well, good job, Cecilia. By the way, if you're wondering, those blue coffin things that we've been moving around, you have to move those in order to unlock the doors in this place. Oh good, a preemptive strike. That's nice. So when you move one and you see the place shake, that means that you opened up, like, the stairway that leads to the next floor. You don't have to burn all of it, but I always do. Lots of tiny edges. Also, something I haven't pointed out yet. Attacks that hit groups of enemies, well, yeah, they hit groups of enemies. It doesn't mean every enemy. It means all enemies that are grouped together in the selection box down there. Like, there's two groups here. There's what, a group of three and a group of two. So that's how that works. We'll be right back. we go. Here's where we're going to learn Jack's next fast draw. Of course, I get a battle interrupting me. Because why not? Oh, this is easy. And of course, Cecilia is not strong enough to kill these things either. Okay, now, with that out of the way, let's open up all these exploding chests. Get a bunch of heal berries, as you can see. Then try to go back up, and... yep. Load-bearing chests. There we go! That is the fast draw hint for Meteor Dive, which... that's a move that I'm going to be using a lot for Jack. Hopefully we can learn it soon. Now that little ledge right there is going to be a shortcut back. Though since I have the escape spell, I could also just use that to warp out of the dungeon once we're done here. But there are chests up there, so I guess I'll take some of the shortcuts just to get the chests. Ah, we didn't learn it. I need to make sure Jack's luck is at best. Because that does help in learning fast draws. Pan, get that for me. Thank you. Three hobgoblins. What are these guys weak to? They're weak to freeze, maybe? No, they are not. Oh wait, what am I doing? I need to be learning Meteor Dive. Oh, there we go, we learned it. Good. That is going to be a very good ability. Because as you saw it... wow, they all dropped heat salves, but as you saw, it does pretty much equal damage to Rudy's arm right now. Did the tree attack me? Nah. Oh goody, I got ambushed. Oh good, finally, counterattack again. That helps speed things along. Yet to encounter a certain enemy in this place, which I'm kind of wanting to and also not wanting to encounter. Wanting to just for the sake of showing it off, not wanting to because it's essentially as strong as a boss. Although I'm like 90% sure it's weak to the freeze spell, so we should be able to fare against it. I should heal everyone up to max HP though, just in case I do encounter it. I should also remember to actually do that after I get out of battle. Also check on everybody's luck. I'll bring everybody up. Okay, there we go. Mystic Word. Now, that is a left-hand item for Celia, which will... Yeah. It increases her sorcery power and magic resistance. It's pretty much best just to give Cecilia the book items. Because that's generally the best stuff you can give her throughout the game. Because we all know Cecilia ain't no physical fighter. Almost to the peak. Ah, yes, we are. Okay, I'm gonna go ahead... not yet, because we might encounter battles before then. I'm just gonna go ahead and save for now. What did I tell ya? Harpies. Sonic Buster time. Antidote? Okay. Okay, yeah, now is when we want to heal, I believe. Also, use Magic Carrot on Cecilia and on Jack. Okay. We are now prepared for the boss. Which is still just a little bit further up ahead. Oh, gee, where do we push that one? Only two Shriekers. Good. Aw, I was hoping for a triple critical.